we got media from all over the place coming. BBC, ITV.
Yeah, the real deal. BBC.
The kids are doing interviews tomorrow. They've done interviews today. Mm-hmm. They're on Channel 5 tomorrow.
Come on.
Yeah, serious. So, this, you're all part of, you're part of all this.
Thank you for including me in my team.
No. Whatever you can do today, that's going to help get more attention on all of it. And hopefully it will be working for work for you as well. There's a lot of media here, they'll see you hosting it. So help get your name out there.
It's the real deal though. I see some real cameras up there. Yeah, what's going on? Yeah, G. Screen two. Mandem.
You're ready to be famous and all that, yeah?
Yes, of course.
You don't know. Nice. Okay, so I'm in Cineworld right now. Mandem over there. I'm hosting a film thing and I'm going to turn the camera around.
I'm out premiere. BBC have just done their live interviews outside. It's about to kick off.
Locally, by people you can touch, feel, it's real life experiences, all dramatized. So when my cars do come up, please, I call them my cars because I've taken them over my own. That's my, I swear it out. But honestly, when they do come up, remember they are actors. They are portraying a role in a narrative. They are not actually the perpetrators of these crimes, so let's give them an easy time when they're up here. But when they do come up here, I want you to get some questions ready in the back of your mind and that unique takeaway that you can take away from the film. Because remember, where hashtag I'm out is not just today, we want this to be a legacy piece. This project forms part of a wider thing that's going on in Haringey called Haringey Community Gold, which is something that is happening. Yes, come on, give some round of applause. And this is a project that is happening in Haringey that is supporting up to at least 10 plus local organisations to deliver projects in a range of different spheres, not just films, not just actually advocating for knife crime, but also all kinds of serious youth violence in many different forms. So just keep this in your mind, in the back of your head, what was your unique take from the film? How can you share that on social media? How can we keep the conversation going on the website? Well, without further ado, I'd like to invite up here, which isn't a stage, but let's call it a stage. On stage, I'd like to invite Jordan, Ronnie, and Layla, who are three of the people involved in the show. So if we give them a warm welcome.
Hello, hello.
Okay, so this is Ronnie. This is Layla, and then this is Jordan. Let's just give them a warm welcome while we can see them. Swear down. So I've got a few questions. The audience have better questions than me, I hope. Yeah, left wing, right wing, front line, I'm hoping so. But one of the things that I'd like to ask you is, now that you've actually seen the fruits of your labor, I want to put something in the minds of the people, because this took commitment. This wasn't something that you could just film overnight. Amazingly filmed. Big up Alex Barry, because literally, Casual Films, you lot done your thing, I swear that. That is a very, very, like, that felt like a real film. That's like a cinema. But now that you've actually seen the fruits of your labor, and you've actually seen it on the big screen, how, and you've seen it all together in the collection, like, how has that impacted your view of the film? And a second question to that, so how does it feel to see it on the big screen, but also what do you feel you've kind of achieved? Because this is a day of achievement where we're going to recognize you three and the rest of the cast for what you've managed to put together here today. So again, now you've seen it on the big screen, what does it feel like to see yourself up there with Will Smith and all that? But you know what I mean? How does it feel to see yourself on that level, and also what do you feel like you've achieved?
First thing, I'm thankful, because it's not, you know, an ordinary thing for you to get this opportunity. You know, young people, especially from a borough that's not, you know, too privileged like others. It just, it comes down to like every individual at the end of the day is like, how hungry are you, you know, for the things you desire? And it's like, this is my dream, like, although, you know, it's not worldwide yet. So it's like, although it's not worldwide, it's like, it's a privilege to actually see our craft, you know, put into play. You know, this is bigger than I thought. Like, even me standing here, I'm just like, wow, like, so many heads, like, it's crazy. And yeah, it just comes to like, you know, how much are you hungry for certain things? And it's like, with this opportunity, if my teacher comes saying, we've got this thing going on, who did they remember? Jordan, who did they remember? Layla, Ronnie, and, you know, everyone else. Why? Because, you know, we don't wanna, like Akins or the Leon Lucas, like, they left, we all led the gang life in the film. And it's like, that's just the easy way out. You know, that's the easy way out to get off the hard work that you have to go through. But yeah, this is just a clear example that, you know, when you really desire to do something or to get into something, if you put yourself out there, be prepared to get rejected. But if you put yourself out there and actually open your mind, these things happen. It becomes a norm, it becomes normal.
Okay, Ronnie, yeah.
Oh, I just want to say how grateful I am for everyone coming as well. And I did not know that the film was going to be that sad. Like, that actually touched me. I didn't know it was going to be that sad. But I hope it affected you guys as well, as much as I wanted to sit there and cry. But yeah, I just think it's just a great opportunity. And people, especially from Haringey as well, need to know that it's not just people who are on top and you see people like big people doing things. People from Haringey, yeah, as little as you might feel like you are because you haven't got a voice, and like, people might not see us as big stars yet, yeah. We're on the come up, and we're on the come up, yeah, we're coming up. Woo! You have got the chance, and this is the chance.
I just want to say I'm so appreciative, and I know that I wasn't actually a part of the film. You know, there was a part of me where I was asked to do some acting in it, but I didn't feel like I wanted to be necessarily in the film, even though it's an amazing opportunity. I was more sort of production, and I just feel so blessed sort of to be in the room with the type of people that I was with. You know, Casual Films are amazing. They actually listened to everything that we said. They took literally every single part of sort of our emotion, our feeling, and just the youngness in us, and they took it, and they took it away, and they did the best they could to sort of just produce what they could. And I mean, it speaks for itself, it's incredible. The editing, we have to thank Alex here because he's just amazing. And generally, the school, I mean, Haringey Sixth Form College is amazing. It was the last school that I thought I would go to be 100% honest. But I am so appreciative that I did go, because I love what I'm studying. I love the fact that they've given us so many opportunities, and they're so on it. I can't stress it enough. So like she said, and like how he put out there as well, if you really believe in yourself and you have dreams, I think it's 100% possible after being involved in this. So thank you.
This is really important, because something that Layla highlighted is that she said she didn't want to see, or she didn't feel like participating in the film on the screen was where her passion lies. She felt like she would be more effective within the team, because it was always a team effort. It takes more than one person to pull something together like this, and a lot of things in our lives we can take that philosophy and use that approach. It's always going to take some people that might not be visible or visibly seen within the team to actually help execute and pull it off. So I have a question for you. What was it like actually being on set? And this comes with a slight sub question again, I can't help it. But it's like, for instance, this was happening in the real world. So I understand that you was a team of people, you come out to a location.
Hi, I'm Anna O'Neill, I'm from BBC Radio London. So I'm recording this, I hope you don't mind. Woo! My question to you and your question, your answer's back. I thought it was absolutely fantastic. I thought it was beautifully shot. I couldn't tell that you weren't professional actors. You sounded and looked absolutely amazing. But my question is about the points of view in the film. So you had the perpetrator's point of view, and you had the perpetrator's girlfriend's point of view, and you had the victim, the perpetrator's sister's point of view. And I just wondered whether, what was the reasoning behind not choosing a point of view from the victim or the victim's family? Was that deliberate? Was there a reason behind it?
Yeah, so we came up with the idea with these guys because there's been loads of films that have been created from the victim's point of view, and that it doesn't make you stop and think if you're going to go and do that, it's not going to suddenly, like, that doesn't affect you, that doesn't affect your family. So the reason we wanted to do it this way is because it's going to show you what is going to happen to you if you go and commit these crimes. But I like these guys because they... you pretty much said it.
Come on!
So like Alex said, is that, you know, it's always based on the victim, but it's like, it always tends to be the gang leader who has so much about them. And like, you know, Aikens in the film, the perpetrator, he was a caring brother, as we saw in one of the scenes. So there's like, what I actually picked up from this film and like working with these guys is like, I analyzed each and every person, and each and every person has something about them. But, you know, it would be even better if they used it, you know, for better things, instead of, you know, going under, you know, their environment, or, do you know what I'm saying? So, there was something about Aikens that in the real world would have been necessary. He could have used his attributes for useful things, but unfortunately, he used it for silly things. Yeah.
True. Carry that, they have to film all that, they have to edit all that, like there's so many parts to it that I feel like is so underestimated. And you know, my brother, he's an actor anyway, and so I speak with him sometimes, and even he tells me he doesn't like some of the people he works with because they don't respect other people, because they feel like, you know, their head is just too stuck above the clouds and they're not focusing on the fact that it can't be done unless there's a team effort. And 100% I respect you. And would even maybe love to work with you, so yeah.
Can I just say that the front row is taking it back? Have you noticed that? So I had to write mine down. I was breathtaking by that portrayal. It was just amazing and very unique. But I was wondering what you guys think young people will take from this. Do you think they'll see the message, or do you think that they'll be empowered by seeing young people on screen as opposed to the actual message itself?
So in response to that, I believe, honestly, I think they're going to take it with a pinch of salt, which is the most important thing out of it all. Because with a lot of these mediums, what the youth take from it is absolutely nothing but glorifying what's happened. They think that Leon's character is such a big man, you know what I mean? And as Jordan said earlier, there's a lot of aspects which we in the, you know, in the general world, we wouldn't see as part of Leon's character, such as his relationship with his sister. So there's a soft part to Leon which we wouldn't know about at all with the naked eye. But I think from people watching this, they're going to take with a pinch of salt his reaction. You know, this big intimidating guy who's such a big man, you know, he committed the crime of stabbing someone, a victim, you know, with his friend surrounding him. You know what I mean? So he's not exactly the tough guy, but nonetheless, we got to see the weak side of him. We got to see the vulnerable side to him when he got through those cell doors. So yeah, that's what we hope that the youth will take from that, just to push yourself.
Teriy Keys, this has been really nice. We are the real. And good night, everybody. Next week.